Good morning, sir. This is Bodhi Rudra from Senior Technical Engineer from MIDAS India. And today I'm going to present you a short tutorial as demanded by you on construction stages using MIDAS. Okay, so as we have already tried for the webinar, so for that webinar only, I've just prepared a short tutorial kind of thing, video tutorial kind of thing, that will guide you through your queries, whatever queries that you had. So to start with, I will just start by explaining the construction stages, a little brief about construction stages. What does construction stage actually mean? So what is construction stage? So construction stages, as you can see in the slide itself, just state as an exact simulation of construction site. So whatever things that you do on a construction site, whatever things, whatever duration, whatever steps you follow in a construction site, you can similarly simulate that those steps in the software itself using construction stages. So as you can see, you can specify a time dependent material property, okay, and you can specify the duration of each stage. Suppose in stage one you are constructing one segment. So in stage one, for constructing one segment, suppose you are taking around 30 days. So those duration you can specify for each stage. Specify the structure of members you want to activate for each stage. So suppose for first stage I'm activating first two segments. Okay, so I'm doing one, and in one stage I'm doing two segments. So in this way you can activate the structural members, okay, and with the respective age. As you already know, that whatever the age of the concrete member at that time. So whatever is the age of the concrete, you have to specify those in the age of the members. I will explain this afterwards also. Okay, and then you have to specify the boundary constraints. So you have specified the members, but after that you have to specify boundary constraints on which the member will be resting. Okay, and then at the end you have to specify the loads in the members, like the self weight of the member, the crane load, the crane that is on the members. That was your question, right? So the crane of your crane weight and everything, you have to specify on the loads. Okay. So construction stage, a brief about construction stage is that it's a one-stop solution for segmental bridge. As you can see, it is highlighted in the red. So one-stop solution means with just one module, you can do almost everything related to bridges. So you can do, for a segmental bridge, you can find the tendon losses on the basis of time losses, okay? So you can find the lasting deformation loss, the long-term losses, the creep and sinkage losses. You can also define the time dependent material property and get the creep and sinkage stress strain. Okay, you can get hyperstatic effect for a tendon. You can get a tendon loss graph. Also for a free cantilever metal bridge, or balance cantilever, for a segmental bridge, one of the most important thing that is required is the camber calculation. Okay, so these the camber calculation, it automatically provides the construction stage. It automatically provides the camber calculations, so automatically it will find the construction camber and the manufactured camber for along with the manufactured camber, so that you can construct in such a way that at the end the breadth becomes totally level. Okay, so these are the brief about construction stages, how you find the losses, the tendon losses, and FCM camber. So it automatically finds out what is the camber calculation at each stage. Okay, and finally it reduces it to zero. So this way, this is a brief about construction stages. Now we will be discussing a small bridge for a precast member. Okay, a small bridge for this tutorial itself. So the bridge specification, as you can see on your screen, is that we have a two span continuous 60 meter bridge. Okay, so each span is having 30 meters, and it's a continuous bridge, but the support conditions were given as simply supported. Okay, so, and also we haven't modeled the piers here. As you can see, you cannot see the piers here. So we haven't modeled the piers here. We're just taking the pier supports instead. Okay, for simplicity, we are just taking pier supports, and for section type, we have taken box section. Okay, and M40 concrete box section we have taken. So for a precast section, as you already asked me, for a precast section what we need to do. So for a precast section, I will be defining you some stages. Okay, so for a precast section, for stage one, as you can see for stage one, okay, we have duration of 30 days, right? So what we are doing is that while we are on the onset of the construction, we have decided that for stage one segment, and that segment will take 30 days. Okay, so I have taken 30 days as duration. Okay, so first day of the construction stage, we just take the precast member from the manufactured plant, okay, and we place it on the pier. Okay, so the precast member, depending upon the number of days it is in the manufacturing plant, so depending upon the number of days before it was casted, so we get the age of 7 days. So age of 7 days doesn't mean that on the seventh day of the construction stage I am installing the activating the precast member. It means that on the first day of the stage one, my member is already 7 days old. So it was casted 7 days before in the manufacturing plant. Okay, it will be much easily explained in the next slide. So as you can see here, we have a manufacturing plant. Okay, so let there be a manufacturing plant nearby to the construction site. So it was casted 7 days before. It was kept there for 7 days. On the seventh day of this, when the structure age becomes 7 days, this precast member age, we just place it on the, we take it and we place it on the construction site, that is on the pier supports. Okay, so the element age that it becomes 7 days, as you can see in the diagram itself, the element age becomes 7 days. Okay, so again as you can see on the stage one, we have to have the elements, we need the supports, okay, and additionally we need to activate the self weight of the member, right? So self weight of the member has to be activated, because just as the structure becomes activated on the pier, the self weight will start, self weight will also start acting. Okay, so we have to activate the self weight of the member. And additionally, because as you asked that if we have to add a crane load or a non-structural load, how it has to be activated. In that case, we have for the next segment, there will be some crane loads, okay, so there will be some gantry girders. So for those girders and crane load, we can activate a load additionally to the self weight. Okay, so we can activate a non-structural load additionally on the elements, and then we can proceed with it. So our stage one particularly defines these things. Okay, so if I go to the model itself, so we have this model. Okay, we have this model. We haven't activated self weight yet, so I will just activate self weight quickly. Self weight minus one, not close. Okay. SIDL also, so load element SIDL. Okay. Support I'm taking minus 1.5 SIDL. So our SIDL is also activated. Okay, so what we have done is that for in the base stage, as you can note that this is the base. Base stage means the stage where everything is activated, all the loads, all the modeling is done. Okay, so after the modeling, what we have to do is that we have to create some groups. As you can see from the PPT itself, that only first few segments are activated. In the first stage, only few segments are activated. So for these few segments, we need to create some groups. Okay. So for those groups, we go to groups and then we create stage one group and stage two group. Okay. So I will just deactivate the element load. Okay. So we have created stage one group. Stage one group comprising of the first stage elements, and stage two group comprising the second stage element. Okay, similarly we have activated the boundary groups. So there we have BG1 boundary groups. We have activated only first two boundaries, because at first only the first two boundaries will be coming into effect for the distribution of forces. Okay, similarly we have activated BG2 and second stage, and we have three load groups in this example. So we have added a self weight, we have added SIDL, the railing load. The railing load are usually on the edges, but for simplicity I have just taken the same long tail element, okay, and without eccentricity. And we have a form traveler load. Form traveler or a crane load or you can say it as a non-structured load. Okay, it is placed, as you can see, we have placed it near the end of the first stage elements. Okay, so this means the crane will be placed here and the next segment will be placed on the with the help of the crane on the next pier. So after the all these things are defined, we go to the construction stages. So we load construction stage and we define construction stage. Okay, so as you can see here for CS1, okay, for stage 1, from a diagram itself, so from the stage 1, as you can see is here, that we have to activate the stage 1 elements, we have to activate the boundary groups for the stage 1, okay, and we have to activate the self weight of the elements of the load, okay, and we have to activate the non-structural load or crane load on the first stage itself. So we'll just follow these things, okay, and follow these steps, and we'll go to the tutorial again. So we see that in stage one, we just gave an age of 7 days. So duration we have for stage one as 30 days, and age of 7 days, we activate the stage one elements at the age of 7 days. So it automatically takes the 7 days effect, okay. And boundary conditions, again, we have to activate the BZ1 boundary condition. So we have activated the BZ1 boundary condition similarly. And load, again, what we have to do is that we have to activate both these loads. We have to activate both these loads on the first day itself. So, sorry, self weight and form traveler on the first day itself. So we'll just click add like this. And similarly, after the first day is done, we just click apply. Okay. Again, we go to second stage. So similarly, we define the second stage. Second stage, we activated the stage 2 elements with the 7 days age. Boundary group, we have activated BZ2. And load group, we have activated SIDL on the last day. SIDL on the last day because we assume that the construction is over by the end of the stage 2. So now after the construction is over, we are just adding the railings and all. So we activate SIDL on the last day. Also form traveler load, because after this our crane will also form traveler will also be removed from the structure itself. So we will deactivate the form traveler load. As you can see here, we will deactivate the form traveler load from the stage itself. Okay, so after this, again you have to click apply. Okay, and stage 3 has been given. I will just explain you here. So stage 2, we have deactivated the crane load and the non-structural load on the last day itself. SIDL for railings, SIDLs or load for railings are activated on the last day. Okay. So after stage 2, in stage 3, we give a duration of 10,000 days. Usually the last days, we give a long-term duration because to see the effect of creep and sink is on a lifetime basis. Okay. So in this, we don't activate or deactivate any elements, boundaries or loads. Okay. So stage 3, we simply define a 10,000 day stage, okay, and we don't activate or deactivate. Another thing important to note is that we don't activate each and every stage. So in CS2, stage 1 element, we don't have to activate again. Once it is activated, unless and until it is deactivated, it will remain active, okay. So after we have defined the construction stages, we can just follow from this box, okay, and give CS1. So in CS1, you can easily see that if you display the supports, if you display the elastic link also, so you can easily see the supports has been activated, okay, the elements has been activated, and also the non-structural load, the from traveler loads, okay. So here the crane is placed, so crane load is also activated in the member now, okay. Similarly, self weight is already activated, so we can see it from here. So from the tree menu itself, we can find out what loads have been activated and what loads have been deactivated from the stage. So once we go to the CS2, we get the second segment again with the specified boundary conditions. So as you can see, the boundary condition for the CS2 has been activated. Okay, so overall, in the CS2 also, the construction stages, you can see what all loads have been activated. So we have activated SIDL on the last day. Similarly, we have deactivated form tablet load which was there in the first stage. Deactivated the form tablet load on the last day of the construction stage. Okay, and CS3 is similar to the CS2, only the duration is 10,000 days. Okay, another thing, because as you have seen that we have given some age and we have given some age of the concrete, age of the members, so we have to define that age somewhere. So to define that age, we go to properties, and then we add a creep and sinkage property. So we add a creep and sinkage property, add CNS. So we are using Indian IRC 18 or IRC 112 we use. So for 28 days we are using M40, so we will just give 40,000 and 1 meter thing. Okay, so I will just click show results. So once you click show results, you will see a time dependent curve for creep coefficient. Similarly, you can see a time dependent curve for sinkage strain. So automatically, depending upon the duration of the stage and the elements when it is activated and the age of the elements, it will define the time dependent, it will give the time dependent material property. Okay, so we just close it, we apply it. Okay, and this can only be done in base test, so we have to go to the base test first. So we go to the base test, again go to properties, creep and sinkage, add. Okay, so creep and sinkage, I give CNS. So I give Indian RC 112, 40,000, 1 meter here, show result. Okay, so creep and sinkage, creep coefficient and sinkage strain, and click apply. Similarly, we have to define the compressive strength of the concrete as per the time. So development of compressive strength can be defined from here. So we just give COMB compressive strength, define the, and we select the code, and we select 40,000 as the mean compressive strength, normal strength. So we draw graph. So once we do it, so you can see at the end of 28 days, it almost attains the full compressive strength. So these things, because as you already know that we have given an age of 7 days to the member. We have given an age of 7 days, so it will automatically take the 7th day compressive strength. So it will automatically take this compressive strength around 30,000 for the member at that time. So it is a very accurate analysis when we are doing construction stage using MIDAS Civil. Okay, so we go to the properties again. Now, because you can see it in blue, so it has been defined but it hasn't been assigned to any material. To assign to a material, we have to go to properties, material link. Okay, we have to select the creep and sinkage, compressive strength, deck, add, close. So we have assigned the creep and sinkage material, we have assigned the time dependent material also with the material property. So after all these things are done, we just analyze it. After the analysis is over, you can go to CS1 and post CS. So you get both construction stage results and post construction stage results. Okay, so you can go to CS1 to see the result for construction stage of CS1. You can go beam diagrams. Okay, so you just select CS dead load, click apply. So you can see a beam diagram of the construction stage load. Remember that for construction stages, we have a specific set of load cases that it automatically generates. So we have a dead load, we have erection load, we have creep sinkage, creep secondary, sinkage secondary. So you can see the creep secondary value, sinkage secondary value. Similarly, we can give summation value. Since we haven't defined any pre-stressing, so we don't see any pre-stressing results here. But it will automatically generate a pre-stressing result also along with the these load cases. Now suppose you want to differentiate the crane load, the effect of crane load, you want to differentiate from the self-weight here. Because crane load also has been defined as a dead load, so it has been defined as a dead load, and self-weight also has been defined as similarly dead load. So both the results are coming under dead load. So to define it separately, what we do is that we go to pre-processing mode. So from here, from the lock position, we go to the unlock position, the pre-processing mode. And then we go to analysis construction stage. So these analysis construction stage, again I will show analysis. This is analysis control. So in analysis control, you have control for various type of analysis. So for construction stages, we will just go to analysis construction stage. So from the analysis control, you can see various options here. Okay. So to differentiate the form tablet load from self weight, so what we can do is that we can use this menu, load cases to be distinguished from the dead load of for CS output. So what we can do is that we can just select the load case and click add. So automatically the form tablet load will be shown to you under erection load. As you can see here, this load type will be shown under erection load. Okay, so you notice that we had dead load and erection load. So the form tablet load effect will be shown erection load. Okay, so once we click OK now, okay, and then we analyze. Okay, so now when we go to CS1, forces, beam diagrams, erection load. Okay, so you can see the effect of the form tablet load in the erection load. So this way you can separate the dead load from the self weight from the erection load also. Okay, so this is a short demonstration of how to do constraint stages for a cast in situ member. For a precast member, I will just show you a slide itself how to do it. So this was a small demonstration on how to do a precast member in constraint stages. Okay. So now I will be showing you how to do a cast in situ. So when you are doing cast in situ, what you have to do is that on the bridge itself, we lay a formwork for the next segment, and then we pour the wet concrete. And when the wet concrete attains its green strength, then only it becomes a structural member. Unless and until it attains its green strength, it is still a weight. It still acts as a load. Okay. So for explaining this, we can go back to the presentation itself. So for cast in situ sections, as you can see in the diagram itself, okay, for cast in situ section, as I've explained you that we need to give a wet concrete load and a form tablet load for each and every segment. So initially in the base test, as you can see in the base test, we have to define a form tablet load and the wet concrete load together. Okay. So once we have defined the form tablet load and wet concrete load in the first stage, in the base stage, now we can just activate those form tablet load for each and every element and deactivate it afterwards. Okay, because as you know the form tablet will move from one segment to another segment to cast the next segment, right? So in that case, we have to remove the form tablet load from the next stage and we have to activate the form tablet load for the next segment. Similarly, we have to remove the wet concrete load of the previous segment and activate the wet concrete load for the next segment which has to be casted. This can be more easily explained in the next slide. As you can see in the dotted element, this is the next segment that we are going to cast. So in this element, this element is still not a structure element yet. Okay, so it is not behaving as a structure element. It is not participating in the load distribution. So we just activate this element as a wet concrete load. So what we do, we just activated load of the wet concrete, okay? And similarly, you can see form tablet load. So we activate the form tablet load in this segment, this present segment that we are working on, okay? So we activate the crane load of form tablet load here. Once the stage is over, in the next stage, we activate this element and we deactivate the wet concrete loads. So what you can see here is that since these elements are already activated, so wet concrete on these elements are deactivated. Okay, if you don't deactivate the wet concrete load, what will happen is that because the self weight of a structural element is already accounted for, so the self weight and the wet concrete load will be counted double in a way. Okay, so this is how you do a cast in situ constraint stage. I will just show you in a model how it has been done. Okay, so in a model, as you can see in the base test, okay, so we have activated the full element, full form tablet loads and the wet concrete loads. Okay, so we have activated all the form tablet loads and wet concrete load. So once you go to stage one, we can see that we have a form tablet load on the first segment, okay, and a wet concrete load for the next segment is activated on this segment itself, on this node itself. Okay, next we go to CS. So we can just go, just click on this button. Just click on this button to see what are there in this segment, in this stage. Okay, so we go to CS1. So we can see that in the loads, we have activated form tablet load. We have activated wet concrete load at the 7th day. So once we have activated the wet concrete load on the 7th day, what it means is that the total duration of the stage is 12 days, right? 7th day we have activated the wet concrete load. It means that on the 7th day we are casting the segment, right? So at the start of stage 2, once we are activating the segment 2, so it is an age of 5 days. So 12 minus 7, it is an age of 5 days. Okay. Similarly, then in loads we have to deactivate the form tablet load and wet concrete load in the next stage. So as you can see in the next stage, CS2. Okay, CS2, what we have done is that we have activated the form tablet load 2 and activated the form wet concrete load for the next segment, and we have deactivated the form tablet from the previous segment and the wet concrete from the previous segment also. Okay, so I hope this clears your doubt. I hope this clears your doubt. And for further queries, I would like you to mail us at techsupport@midascity.com. So this is our global support. So anytime if you have any doubt, anything, any query, so you can just mail us to techsupport@midascity.com. So we have a group of technical engineers. So anyone who is free at that time, he will get back to you within one day. Okay. So thank you so much. I hope this short demonstration helped you a lot in clearing your doubts. So for further queries, just come back to us. I will just send you this PPT and send you the tutorial files and the demo and the model files. And I would like you to work on this problem and then come back to us with some queries. Thank you so much.